I'm going to show you how to write a simple little macro that will check to see if fields have been completed on your sheets. I have a very simple example here. I have a sheet that's asking for your first name and your last name. So let's go to the Developer tab. Let's go to Visual Basic. And then we will go Insert and we'll go New Module. So I'll drag this over here so you can see it. And so I'm going to call my sub got info. So we'll go sub got info. Okay, and I'm going to put end sub is what my little thing means here. And so let's go to the start here, and I'll say, so the fields that we're looking at, if I pull this aside, so it's C4 is for the first name. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go if, and where you can use the command is empty. And then I'm going to go range. And then I'm going to do another bracket and I'm going to put quotation marks and I'm going to go C4. And then I'm going to put another quotation marks and brackets. And maybe another bracket to end this for the range. Then I'm going to go, if that's empty, then. And we're going to create a message box. And it's going to say enter first name. And then I'm going to put a little fail safe in it. So I'm going to go to an ENDS to go to my bottom here. So. So if that one's fine, let's go to the next one. So we'll go else. And we'll go same thing. If is empty. And we'll go range. And we'll go another bracket. And I'll go quotation marks E4. And end of quotation marks, end of bracket, and then I'm going to go then. And if that's empty, then we're going to generate another message box. So we're going to go MSGBOX, and I'm going to say, enter last name. We got an extra quotation mark. Okay, we're good. Now, same thing is we're going to go to okay, so the big thing about ifs is you have to count your ifs. We got 1, 2, and so we're going to have two end ifs. So we'll go END if, and then we're going to do another end if. So just because I don't always trust myself, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the debug on the ribbon here, and I'm going to go debug, and I'm going to go compile VBA project. And it doesn't appear that there is anything wrong with it. So now I'm just going to go off to the side here. And so I'm going to run this program. And so we can see our sheet a little bit back here. So there's nothing in either one of them. So let's see what happens. So, and then the message box, enter first name. And so I'm going to say OK. And so the program goes to the end because we don't have a first name in there. So now let's put in Barney. OK, and so let's run our program again. So let's run it. And see, it went past the Barney, and now it's gone to the last name, saying you've got to enter the last name here. And so we'll say OK. And I'm going to put in Rubble. Okay, and then let's run our program one more time. And there is no error message come up, so it's working perfectly. So that's a simple little macro just to test if fields have been completed. Please subscribe.